Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Life is Better with Music with Gavin and Mitchell. Sorry we had to take a week off. It got kind of hectic for us both. I had started my new position at my company and had color guard auditions I had to judge too that week or last week. So everything kind of got hectic to where I wasn't even getting home till after our normal recording time. And he had a bunch of stuff going on, I think
Concerts,
school-wise and
exams, travel.
Everything going on. So last week, just kind of a week, and I called him Monday on my way home. I'm like, yeah, I think we need to reschedule and just push this the next week because, like, I won't even be getting home till about whatever time I was getting home that night. And yeah, so, but we're back now, back to WGI, like we promised. I know we have a lot more shows we can look up on. We got a nice show from Winds, Guard, and Percussion. So we'll do that same
We've
format just
also
so
got
we
some scores
and some
from,
scores we can look at.
yeah,
That's on the
there's some
website I can
pretty.
go on it,
I
right?
got I can pu I can pull it up right now. As I say, I
Is
got
it
it
off
up
the
already.
website?
Yes, I'm particularly looking at Color Guard and the Avon competition.
You see everything.
Yes, I do.
So you said color guard.
Yes, if it'll. There we go.
What show do you want?
I want to look at the Avon Color Guard finals.
Which one?
Scores.
So where do you exactly want to look?
Oh, you know where I want.
Oh, this right
Yep.
here.
Yep.
Okay, congrats, Carmel.
El Bozo.
And then Pride of Cincinnati. You know, we got all our independent worlds kicking some butt over here.
Alexis. Yeah, Alexis from Lexington. Let's go.
Allegiance, Bellbrook High School, the Magnolia Project
That's
for
a cool
Independent A,
name.
Scholastic A, Piqua?
Piqua, yeah. They do
Piqua?
BOA. They do BOA.
I was about to say, that name sounds familiar. Mount Vernon. Carmel.
Yeah, it's our A guard.
Carmel High School A guard. Does Avon have an A guard?
No.
Or is it just their World Guard?
I think they have a second guard. I don't think they I don't think they competed that weekend.
Is there any more other ones you want to specifically look at for color guard?
Not particularly.
Houston. I don't want to look at Houston real quick. Let's see what we
That's
got over here.
prelims.
It is.
Yes. Yes, sir, Mr. Bozo, sir.
Aha, there it is. Okay. You know, we got some common names, the Woodlands out here.
You got the Woodlands World Guard that
Woodlands.
they have.
Independent Third Coast, Lake Area Independent, some Houston State. Cedar Park High School. I mean, a lot of these names, like they're popping out to me, but they're not like the Texas BOA band names that I'm like popping out
Texas
right over to me.
Color Guard outside of the Woodlands is kind of, I don't want to say rough, because it's not rough. It's just not what you, it's not
Not as
wins.
full.
No.
Not as full. We'll go with that. Percussion. Like it's just like two percussion scores, roughly. Jump on into here.
Yeah, we got some Indiana scores I know that are out from a couple
Oh.
I don't know if perk competitions have started yet. Let me just research. Let me just real quickly double check.
Maybe not then. Maybe they haven't. Nor
Let's
maybe
see.
not wins either.
There are some Indiana wins scores. I know that and Indiana percussion scores and color guard scores as well. Particularly, I know Westfield has had a couple shows now, for their wins, which is really, really cool. Let's see, Northview maybe.
Ah, yes, they have not.
Let's see.
So percussion events for WGI, February 25th.
Scores.
I'm assuming the same for the wins.
So, Norwell High School in Indiana had February 11th. Word, sorry. They had a wins event. Let's see if I can find the scores. Norwell High School scores. So in Winscholastic, you had Kokomo winning, which is about an hour away from me. You had in Scholastic Open, you had Westfield Winds winning because they were the only one in their group with 73.2. And then for Scholastic World, you had Avon Winds with a 77.2. And this was a couple weeks ago now. This will be 2 weeks from this upcoming Saturday. So they've obviously done some more work on it and cleaned their shows more. But that's, you know, a pretty solid starting point out, I'd say.
That's good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, so it seems like Color Guard have had 2 weekends before percussion wins. They start this weekend, the other two. But, I mean, besides for that, we're slowly getting into the bulk of WGI. So we got one of each here. We got Pride of Cincinnati 2023 at Avon. We got Music City 2023. And then we got Strike Wins 2023.
Strike Wins, I've been told, is really good this year.
We'll save them for last time.
Yeah, Strike Wins, their visual staff works with cadets. The visual caption head at cadets is the visual caption head at Strike. Sorry, words are hard.
Okay. Well, let's start with Pride of Cincinnati then.
Yeah.
Can you hear it?
Yeah.
Not the screen recording of the float marching.
Bruh. Are we gonna get copyright striked?
I hope not. It's on YouTube. Didn't we watch Pride of Cincinnati's show last year?
Yes.
Okay.
It's an ABBA song.
Cool tosses. Saw nothing.
I heard it.
I didn't pay attention. Which means wherever it happened, if it did happen, it wasn't that noticeable for me. Where's the pit?
Okay.
That was cool. Do you prefer rifle or saber?
Rifle.
Rifle. Good answer. I like saber. The rifle just has that kick to it. Saw that one. Nice little show. I like that one.
Yeah, it was cool.
What were your thoughts?
I thought it was nice. I thought I'm obviously proud of Cincinnati is proud of Cincinnati, and you know they're fantastic at what they do. I really enjoyed it. I think it's definitely going to be really good this year and really tough to beat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so as you guys heard earlier, like I said last week, I was judging a color guard camp. This high school I worked with just for their band camp this past summer, Bloom Carroll High School. My friend, she's the color guard director there. I became friends with her. Like her husband and me and my wife were kind of like, we're all like besties now. So She invited me to go be a leadership and visual judge for her color guard auditions. So I went there and learned a lot about color guard, obviously. So watching that, now I'm like, I can judge color guard a lot better now because I went to a little 1 week camp and I got to like how we did auditions and we like pulled four or five in at a time and they did their auditions at the same time. And I can easily tell who's out of time and just, you know, who is performing at a higher level. So it was basically we're auditioning for their color guard for the next season for this next fall. So seeing who will make it into that color guard. So it was fun. I learned a lot of things from it. And, you know, I'm glad I took the week off to focus on that because it was definitely a learning experience. So, Mitchell, you got to do that now so you can easily judge color guard. So you can have a lot better idea of judging color guard, I should say. Because I didn't see any saber stuff. They don't do sabers there. But really? Yeah. And that director, I think she may help out at Licking Heights this year, which would be cool. So Also on the side here, not Blue Coast 2022 finals.
That's definitely not it.
I was about to say.
That's it. That's very much so there? It.
Okay. That's Music City.
That's very much it. That is 100%. That is the true Blue Coats 2022. Instead of the lame bozo costume. Music City costume.
Thank you.
Music City Mystique's a really good drum line.
That was it. I felt like it went by so fast.
I guess
was a good show.
Maybe
I want to see
how the
rest of the season goes for them. That's awesome.
Yeah, they sounded really good. They sounded pretty clean already too, which is impressive. Early season.
Music City kicking butt.
Yeah, Music City Mystique is really good. And I just want to clarify, I am 95% certain they are not associated with Music City, like Drum Corps.
Well, in this realm, they're Music City to me.
Right.
I'm calling them Music City.
Yeah.
Music City of the WGI world. Music City Mystique. Okay. Strike Winds. Of course, spelt weird. I'm gonna watch about Halloween next time.
Okay. There's a hole.
Did you hear they're playing?
And then there's a hole in the back. Back right.
Dang. I can already read Mitchell's mind on this.
Huh?
I can already read your mind about what you're gonna say in response to this show.
Sorry.
The beginning is very, very soloistic.
I mean, yeah. But
which is no problem, again. It's
I think it's more appropriate with.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. It's fine. But I know how you are with soloistic stuff.
I don't hate solos, like, at all.
I mean, soloistic. How many mellows they got? Is that four? Maybe five? That'll make one. Six? Seven? I don't know. How many are there?
I don't know.
Or are they marching French horns?
They don't. No, God, no. They don't have their uniforms yet. Same with Music City Mystique. They didn't have their uniforms yet either.
It's like a just to kind of show off the show.
Yeah.
Which I guess is cool, hides the mystery, so if we watch the show later in the season again, we'll see the change. Thank you. Get another quick show. I mean, I know that obviously it's not their full show, but
no, it's not their full show. They're just putting on what they have ready.
But even for 4.5 minutes, that felt really fast, which means
yeah, it did.
Good show.
Yeah, I liked it. I mean, it's soloistic, but in wins, it's more acceptable for me.
Yes.
In marching band, I feel like it should be more ensemble. Like, sure, I'm fine with a couple soloists, but I think
brain
it's
farting.
More, yeah, sorry, also ADHDing. ADHD is fun. It's so much fun. I think it's more of a, I think a marching band needs to be more of an ensemble, not a soloistic solo every like minute or every other minute.
I get it. I just had a feeling you were gonna say something about soloistic.
I don't have a problem with solos and wins and indoor wins. I think it's fine.
Okay. Now that we got that covered. I mean,
they sounded good though. They sounded really, sounded very fantastic.
I'm excited to see where those last two shows go. I mean, and Pride Cincinnati's, but especially those two shows because there's no costume, nothing. So
right.
I'm excited to see where those two shows go this for the rest of this year, along with Pride of Cincinnati's. What else they're going to put on. And, I mean, good luck to those. Good luck to them. Hopefully another episode we'll watch kind of to see what's changed throughout the season. Maybe later in the season we'll watch an episode of that. But besides for that, next week we're jumping back into show choir. We got a bit of stuff we got to catch up on over there. Have to watch a show or two and look at some scores and of some of these bigger competitions. See who's in contender for the show choir cup and see who's going to be pulling through for that awesome opportunity. Let me
see something. I have a big announcement actually. I have decided to make the decision to take the summer off and pursue other interests in terms of, you know, marching arts as well as teaching and whatnot, and, you know, maybe doing some other stuff over the summer, maybe doing some fun traveling opportunities. But, you know, that's something I'm looking forward to. But, you know, of course, sure, I would have wanted to march my drum corps age out, but, you know, where one door closes, another door opens. So, you know, we're gonna sit this one out.
Dang straight. There's always opportunities in the music community. Speaking of which, there are still host spots open for us. So if you want to join us this summer and maybe even meet up at some drum corps competitions, future BOA competitions, maybe even some WGI ones this year, make sure to go to the contact page on the website and reach out to either of us or the company email. Either way works. So, but I mean, besides that, if you're interested, reach out to us. All the information we'll provide for you regarding that. If you want to become a host or if you want to just kind of be featured on an episode. And speaking of which, we have to get somebody on in the next couple episodes. That's a secret for now. But besides for that, make sure to tune in for show choir next week. Even if you haven't performed in show choir, please learn it. Again, I never performed in color guard. And just watching their auditions this week and judging them and, you know, talking leadership with them, very eye-opening for me because I got to see, like, how their routines go firsthand. So it was definitely an experience. So I recommend if anyone has that opportunity to take it. But besides for that, thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch y'all next week when we talk about the Show Choir Cup. Peace out.